Hello everyone, my name is William. Today I'm going to explain Kahn's algorithm, an intuitive topological sort algorithm that is very easy to remember and implement. Before we dive into the algorithm, I think it's important for us to understand what a topological sort is, and on what types of graphs we can have topological sorts. I often get the sense that most people struggle to understand topological sort algorithms, not because they're difficult, but because they don't understand what a topological sort fundamentally does. Let's have a look at an example. Suppose you just woke up and you are trying to get dressed for school. There are 6 articles of clothing laying around your room: a shirt, a hoodie, some underwear, pants, socks, and shoes. What you are trying to figure out is in what order you should put on each piece of clothing such that you never run into a situation where you should have put on another piece of clothing before putting on the current item. For example, you always want to put on your socks before putting on your shoes, not the other way around. Similarly, people generally put on a shirt before putting on a hoodie so that they don't need to take off the hoodie, put on a shirt, and then put the hoodie back on. For this particular situation, one possible valid topological ordering on how to get dressed is the following. First, put on your socks, then your shirt, followed by your hoodie, underwear, pants, shoes, and then you're ready for school. Of course, there's more than one way to get dressed. You could have put on your underwear before putting on your socks, or put on your shirt after having put on your pants. Let me know in the comments what your favorite topological ordering is for getting dressed. There are many real-world situations that can be modeled as a graph with directed edges where some events must occur before others. The most popular example is probably program build dependencies, where you want to figure out in which order you should compile all the program's dependencies such that you never try and compile a dependency for which you haven't first built all of its dependencies. So when we're talking about topological sort algorithms, what we're really interested in is being able to generate a topological ordering of the nodes in the graph. More formally, a topological ordering is an ordering of the nodes in a directed graph where for each directed edge from node A to node B, node A appears before node B in the ordering. This is just another way of saying that we are able to find a way to align all the nodes in a straight line and have all the edges pointing to the right. In that situation, the topological ordering of the nodes can be read from left to right. It's often the case that a graph has multiple valid topological orderings, and in general, any of them will suffice. Going back to our example of getting dressed, it doesn't so much matter in what order you get dressed, so long as you get dressed without any issues. One thing to keep in mind is that only certain types of graphs have topological orderings, and those are directed acyclic graphs. A directed acyclic graph is a directed graph with no directed cycles. I took the time to draw a few graphs on this slide. Pause the video and take a moment to determine which of these graphs are directed acyclic graphs and which ones are not. So graph 1, 3, and 6 all have directed edges and no cycles, hence they're all directed acyclic graphs. Graph 2 has undirected edges instead of directed edges, so it's not a directed acyclic graph. Graphs 4 and 5 have directed cycles, so they're not directed acyclic graphs. Take a moment and think about why we require the graph we're trying to find the topological sort of not to contain any cycle. Try and imagine what happens if you try and find the topological ordering of a graph that does contain a cycle. First, we would pick node 4, because node 4 is the only node without any dependencies. Then you could process node 1, which no longer depends on node 4, followed by node 0, which no longer depends on node 1. Then you would get stuck in a cycle because every node depends on another node. So you could try and process node 2, but before you can do that, you need to process node 5. But to process node 5, you need to process node 3, and node 3 depends on node 2, where we started. So the problem has no solution, and that's why we ban cycles. As we will see, Kahn's algorithm is able to detect whether the graph we're trying to find the topological sort of contains a cycle or not. Let's start talking about Kahn's algorithm. The intuition behind Kahn's algorithm is very simple. It is to repeatedly remove nodes without dependencies from the graph and add them to the topological ordering. As nodes without dependencies and their outgoing edges are removed from the graph, new nodes without dependencies become free. We repeat this process of removing nodes without dependencies from the graph until all nodes are processed or a cycle is discovered. Let's look at a quick example of how we would find the topological ordering of the following graph with Kahn's algorithm. First, we would begin by selecting node 2, since it is the only node without dependencies. Then we would add node 2 to the topological ordering and remove it from the graph. Now, node 0 and node 4 don't have dependencies, so we can select either one to be added to the topological ordering. In this example, I selected node 0 arbitrarily. Add node 0 to the topological ordering and remove it from the graph. Now node 4 is the only node without dependencies, so it is next to be selected. Then add node 4 to the topological ordering and remove it from the graph. This process continues until all nodes are removed from the graph. I'm going to let the animation play for the next 3 nodes. And that's Kahn's algorithm in a nutshell. Now I want to look at a slightly larger example in some more detail. Alright, here's another graph. Feel free to pause the video and try to find a topological ordering of the nodes on this graph. Remember that the topological ordering you find may be different than the one I find because topological orderings are not always unique. In this example, we're going to look at what additional information we need to track to execute Kahn's algorithm. The first bit of information we need to keep track of is the incoming degree of each node. The degree of each node is important because it allows us to know whether a node has dependencies or not. For example, node 6 has an incoming degree of 3 because there are 3 edges pointing to node 6, and node 7 has an incoming degree of 1. Now that we know what the indegree of a node is, we can go ahead and calculate the indegree of each node and store it in an array. The way we're going to keep track of which node to process next is with a queue. The queue on the left will keep track of all the nodes we need to visit which have no incoming edges. Let's go ahead and add all the nodes with a degree of 0 to the queue. Notice that if a node has an indegree of 0, that it has no incoming edges. These are all the nodes in the graph with no dependencies. For now, that includes nodes 0, 9, and 13. Once we've finished initially adding all the nodes with no dependencies to the queue, so long as the queue is not empty, we remove the node from the front of the queue and add it to the topological ordering. Here we remove node 0 from the front of the queue and add it to the topological ordering. Now remove node 0 from the graph and decrease the degree of all affected nodes. Notice that with node 0 gone, the degree of nodes 2, 6, and 3 have all decreased by 1. Now add any new nodes with an incoming degree of 0 to the queue. Since we removed node 0, node 3 has no more dependencies, so we can add it to the top of the queue. Node 9 is next in line, so remove it from the queue and add it to the topological ordering. Remove node 9 from the graph and decrease the degree of all affected nodes. Add any new nodes with an incoming degree of 0 to the queue. This includes node 2 and node 10. Remove node 13 from the front of the queue and add it to the topological ordering. Remove node 13 from the graph and decrease all affected nodes. You will notice that node 13 has no outgoing edges, so no new node degrees are updated. Next, remove node 3 from the queue and add it to the topological ordering. Remove node 3 from the graph and decrease the degree of all affected nodes. Add any new nodes with an incoming degree of 0 to the queue, and so on. I will let the animation play try and follow along. And that's how you find the topological ordering of a graph with Kahn's algorithm. Let's have a look at the topological ordering we found and make sure that the ordering is valid. You can verify the ordering you found by going through the nodes in the topological ordering from left to right and make sure that no node you process has dependencies that are unaccounted for. So the first node is 0, then 9, 13, 3, 2, 10, 1, 6, 7, 11, 4, 12, 5, and 8. Awesome. Now that we understand how Kahn's algorithm works, let's have a look at some pseudocode. The topological sort algorithm takes as input a directed acyclic graph G, represented as an adjacency list. First, get N, the number of nodes in the graph, and then initialize the in-degree array with a size of n to track the degree of each node. The first thing we do is actually count the degree of each node by looping through all the edges of the graph. Whatever node an edge points to gets incremented by 1 in the in-degree array. Afterwards, loop through all the edges of the graph and add all the nodes with an incoming degree of 0 to the queue. Then I initialize two variables, index and order. The order array will contain the topological ordering when the algorithm is complete, and the index variable keeps track of the next insertion position inside the order array. The index variable gets incremented every time a node is added to the topological ordering. So while there are still nodes to process in the queue, execute the following block of code. Remove the node at the front of the queue and add it to the topological ordering. Then simulate removing a node from the graph by decreasing the in-degree of all affected nodes. If we detect that a new node has a degree of 0, add it to the queue. Now outside the main loop, after the algorithm is complete, check that the index value is equal to n. If it is not, that means that not all nodes in the graph were processed and that a cycle was found. Otherwise, return the topological ordering. Awesome, that's all for this video. I hope you learned something. The source code for Kahn's algorithm can be found on GitHub at github.com/WilliamFizet/algorithms. Please like this video and subscribe for more mathematics and computer science content. Thank you.